Welcome to online class for class 5th English. Today we are going to learn the interesting poem, The Kitten at Play. Here children, the kitten. Everyone will like cat? Yes, the cat baby will call that kitten. Here we can see the tree and the kitten. Means here, have you ever seen animals play? Means any animal like dog or cat or parrot or any animals. Not only animals, birds also. Okay. I think you saw most like dog. Dog, it will play with us also, then it will play with ball. Like cat also, it will play with us, then it will play nicely. We can see many animals it will play. Next, have you discussed your experience with your friends and you have to describe the same means? Now, which animal you saw? For example, dog. How it play? Like that, you can share with your friends and you can explain. Then, do you like watching animals at play? You like the animals playing? Yes, everyone will like the animals playing because we love animals. In last class, we learned that nature's friend. In that, the poet described as a, I love nature, so you also to love the nature too. Here, the poet William Wordsworth. The poet William Wordsworth, he wrote, The Kitten at Play. He describes here in this poem about kitten. Okay children, have you seen a bullfight or a cockfight? Have you saw the bulls? In the fair we can see, or in Andhra we can see like the Sankranti festival, the cocks will fight. Then we can see in Dasara festivals also, then Holi time. We can see the cocks fight and the bullfight. Okay children, now come to the poem. Today we are going to the new poem, that is The Kitten at Play. Who wrote? The poet William Wordsworth. He wrote the poem Kitten Play. Okay children, in the poem The Kitten Play is written by William Wordsworth. The kitten crouches and stretches, paws and dots in the morning. Here what it's doing, see? Come to the page number 91. We can see there, see the kitten on the wall. Where we can see the kitten? On the wall. Sporting with the leaves that fall. Here we can see the leaves. Leaves, we can see. Leaf is a singular. Leaf is a singular. But in plural, what we will call? Leaves. Only one. Leaf means only one. But leaves means many. Here we can see the leaves, many. So, sporting with the leaves that fall means the leaves are falling down. We tried leaves 1, 2 and 3 falling from the elder tree. Here big tree was there. Big elder tree. There the leaves are falling down. Means that the name of kitten here described by the poet is Tabby. The kitten name was Tabby. The poet described the kitten name is Tabby. Here he told Tabby. See, through the clam and frosty air of the morning bright and fair, see the kitten how she starts. Means how she started here. First what she did? See, saw the wall. First the kitten saw the wall. Then sporting with the leaves. Here the leaves are falling down. The leaves is in plural form. Here it was falling down. So from the elder tree. Here we can see the big huge tree we can see. The leaves are falling down. So the kitten was sporting with the tree. Okay children. Through the clam and frosty air of the morning bright and fair. See the kitten how she starts. Like what she's doing? Crouches, stretches, paws and drags. With a tiger leap of way. It looks like a tiger. Means off like a tiger. The name of the kitten here described, the poet was described, Tabby. It plays with the withered leaves that fall down from the old tree. which festival we will celebrate, and summer and rainy and winter. Already we learned in the last classes like seasons also, then in which season which festival we will do. Here the kitten was playing in which season? Winter. In winter season which festival we will celebrate? Like we will celebrate Christmas. Now here we can see that now she makes her coming prey, means here the tiger catches falling leaf only to let it go, and again it catching it back as fast as she could. Here the poet compares the kitten with a Indian kangaroo. Then it gratefully plays its part without. Okay children, we'll see next week, continue in the next class. Now come to the grammar part. Here we can see like these words, for example pray, pray, but pronunciation is same, but here we can see the spelling, the difference between spelling. We can see these words means like these words sound the same but have a different meaning. Here we can see that and spelling, they are called homophones. What do we call homophones? Means see, pray, pray, sound is same, then but spelling is different here, meaning also different, so we call that homophones. And way, way, fair, fair, we can see here pronunciation same but spelling is different and the meaning also different. Okay children, now come to page number 93. We can see that these words sound same but have different meaning and spelling. Come to the first picture, we can see the picture. What is that? That is a fair. Which spelling here we have to write? Now here I will show you. Okay, first speech, first we have to write here fair. Yes, that is a fair. We love fair. Every children we like fair. Fair means jatre. Next, next, what is the next picture? What is that? Face. Here you have to write face. You have to write this face. Next picture, what is that? Pray. We can see that picture is pray. Next one, pray. You will pray God, no? Yes, that's pray. Next one, way. Now we have to go this way only. We will say way. Third one, we can see that picture way. Okay, last, what is it? Wait. Here this way we will find out like what we will say. For example, vegetables or fruits, we have to see the meanings. This way we will use. But this way it will show the root. Okay, children, now come to here. See, first picture is way, but next you write this. This pray. But here pray, pray. Way, way. Okay children, we'll continue in the next class.